It's time to sign up for Anchor Club.
And U-turns on Highway 62 are costly. It's Friday, April 18th. The JHS Report is next. Good afternoon, I'm Andrew Steele. JHS students were awakened this morning by an earthquake that measured 5.4 on the Richter scale. The quake centered 40 miles north of Evansville and shook houses, rattled windows, and even knocked bricks off a building in Louisville. JHS reporter Freddie Wilkerson asked some students what they felt this morning.
It was an unfamiliar event that happened today, and Jeff?
That's right, Freddie, and we had a chance to interview some faculty and students about the surprise earthquake.
This morning we had an earthquake. So
what made you wake up this morning?
An earthquake.
I felt shaking everywhere. My dresser was shaking. Everything was shaking.
And how did that feel?
Pretty scary. It was shaking all over the place. And
we felt it all around this area.
And I had some Kool-Aid up on my bedstand and it fell over.
Shaking.
And it was just crazy. And everybody knows my brother Isaiah. I thought it was just him running down the street or something. But
5.4 on the Richter scale, and it occurred just west of the Indiana line. And
did you realize it was an earthquake?
No, I thought I was dreaming.
First earthquake you ever felt?
Yes.
Good afternoon, I'm Sadie Franklin. JHS students have been finding out the hard way not to do U-turns on Highway 62 near the Jeff High entrance. JHS reporter AJ Castro has more. Auditions for the talent part of Baccalaureate will be held after school Thursday, April 23rd. Sign-ups are being accepted in the front office. And don't forget the Jeff High Art Show starting May 7th through the 14th. It's time to apply for membership for the 2008-2009 Anchor Club. The community service organization for females is affiliated with the Pilot Club of Jeffersonville. Prospective members must have good attendance, no discipline issues, and a 2.5 or above overall GPA. Applications are located in the main office and in the media center and are due by May 14th. Current members must reapply. See Ms. Molnar for any questions.
The Jeff High class of 2004 left a $600 scholarship for a class of 2008 senior. Anyone interested in the scholarship should apply with their counselor no later than April 30th. Applications must be turned in by Wednesday.
Rose Holman Homework Hotline is available to 9th through 12th graders for free math and science help. Call toll-free 1-877-ASK-ROSE or visit www.askrose.org. The hotline is available from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. Sunday through Thursday.
The WJHS Report is happy to air your school announcement. There are two ways to do it. You may fill out the form located in the front office or have a staff member email the announcement to Mr. Gross. Please submit those announcements at least 3 days in advance, if possible. We will add the JHS weather forecast plus your latest Jeff High sports after the break.
Yeah. Good afternoon, I'm Brandon Caraway with a look at today's JHS weather forecast. Today, sunshine with a few afternoon clouds, high of 77. Tonight, showers developing late tonight with the possibility of a thunderstorm, low 56. Tomorrow, cloudy with a few showers, high 58. And that's a look at your JHS weather forecast. Now here's a look at JHS Sports with Chris Kokesberger.
Good afternoon, I'm Chris Kokesberger with a look at today's JHS Sports. The Jeff baseball team won 5-3 over Southern last night. Hunter Tipton picked up the pitching victory to move to 3-0 on the year. He also had a home run in the contest. In girls softball, Jeffersonville junior Chelsea Davis pitched a no-hitter as Jeffersonville routed Bedford North Lawrence 9-0. Davis struck out 8 in the victory, Jeff's second straight shutout victory of the week, while helping Jeff move to 6-2 on the season. Sidney Wilcoxon doubled in the win for the Devils. Jeffersonville boys golf team hosted a match against Floyd Central on Wednesday. The final score was Floyd Knobs 168, Jeffersonville 177. John Rogers was our low scorer with a 43. Matthew Thompson and Taylor Stevens both had a 44, and Nathan Morrows had a 46. Attention all boys interested in playing soccer next fall. There is a mandatory players and parents meeting on Thursday, April 24th at 7:30 in the cafeteria. If you and your parents cannot attend, you must meet with Coach Bixler in the gym before April 24th. That's all for Jeff Sports. Now here's a final word from the news desk.
That's not what my juice looks like. That's what my Jesus looks like. My Jesus is a swimmer.
That's not what my Jesus looks like. My Jesus is happy. That's what he looks like.
This isn't what my Jesus looks like. My Jesus is a thinker. That's what my Jesus looks like.
That's not what my Jesus looks like. That's what my Jesus looks like. Muscle man. That's not what my Jesus looks like. That's what my Jesus looks like. And if you accept him for the way he is, he'll accept you and love you for the way you are.
Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed it. And we hope you'll join us every Tuesday for FCA.
We meet in room 201 every Tuesday after school, so meet us there for games, food, and for Bible study. Thanks.
Finally today, you can wish someone a happy birthday on the JHS report. All you need to do is bring 6 pictures and $5 to room 713, and we'll get your greeting on the air. Please bring your greeting at least 2 days in advance. Remember, if you have pictures at WJHS, please stop by and pick them up as soon as possible. Thank you. Now you're up to date with the latest JFI news. I'm Andrew Steele.
And I'm Sadie Franklin. Have a great day, and thank you for doing your part to make Jeff High School a better school.
And thank you for watching the JHS Report. So I signed my name and number.